Yo, welcome back to the Late Night Talk Show. It's Wednesday, and I'm your girl, Leticia, aka Leglelicious.
You forgot one of the A's.
What A's?
You said I'm the girl, Legs, aka Leglelicious, with other A.
AK-47, B, you better recognize.
And I'm your girl, Miss Leesh.
Well, it means drinking rum is okay.
Wait. Khareem, what are you telling the people? Did you... No. You stopped eating Chris. You didn't see no rum. You heard about it. Yo! Hey. It's getting out here. Anyone want to donate some rum to the thing? You get me? With Rain, his nephew, just line up the thing. Must I line it up? So welcome back to the Late Night Talk Show. We are here with the wonderful Mr...
You forgot my name?
No.
Okay.
His name is Khareem Jamal from the School of Africology. Africology.
Thank you.
I told you, I see the words in my mind and I say it how I see it.
Okay.
So I'm not even going to repeat it because I'll probably repeat it wrong again. Well,
it's been saying it, we had never written it down.
No, I haven't. Well, I did write it down, but it wasn't actually in my hand. And if you write with a pen, it's better because it comes through to the mind and it's giving me a pen. Where's the paper?
Well, you know.
Where's the paper at? Where's the paper at? All right, cool. A-F-R-I-C-O-L-O-G-Y. Yeah. See?
Yeah. You got it.
Blessings. Oh, blessings. So guys, we've been, what's that? Tego DiCaprio says hard. Is that the spelling is hard or?
I like that name, Tego DiCaprio. That sounds.
Oh, see, he said Africology.
Okay.
I said it right,
yeah,
isn't it? Well, we're gonna have to listen. Remember, you just said it was your birthday as well, yeah? So, okay. We're gonna have to have a little one shot before you go home tonight.
Wow,
dude, yeah, so cool. So, yeah, so we've been talking about some amazing stuff, guys. If you guys have been locked in, please pass the piece of paper. If you guys have been locked in, we've been talking a lot of stuff about. Black History. It's Black History Month for those of you that are aware of that, and if you don't, then you better get to know. And he said, "What you are talking about is dope. Love that. Oh, blessings. Make sure you lock in for the rest of the month. Just make sure you keep on locking in. It's a late night talk show, and we provide lots of information that you will love to hear us talking about, fun, educational, and all that kind of stuff." So, I mean, I don't want to take up no more time chatting and to me chatting, you know. I don't want to hear my voice. I just want to hear from you because you've just been teaching us a lot of geography-based type of stuff around our culture.
Mm.
And it's just so interesting. It's just so powerful. Just before we went to the ad break, you were talking about... Huh?
I actually know wrong.
Why are you searching for wrong? Oh my gosh. And they locked me in the studio, by the way.
Hello, listen, you're in there with some two lovely ladies here, right? So you'll be looked after. You see, I told you, got rum, we got Chris, we got Chewits, bruv.
Oh,
there you go. So just like sort of without further ado, over more to you. But no, we were talking about... I can't even say. We were talking just before the break. We went on to a little bit of Jewish stuff.
Yeah.
And so forth about that.
You talk about how the classes work.
Yeah, you're talking about Rush, the guy called something Rush he was the one that.
He wasn't the one, but he's
a part of.
Yeah, the one that, disciple of.
The disciple of racism.
Yeah. Well, yeah, you could say that. And of course, he believed that blackness, if you like, was a disease.
Yeah,
hereditary disease that could be cured.
Well, we're still here and we ain't cured. No one ain't cured yet.
Oh, we don't want to be cured.
No. We've got, well, there's nothing to cure because people be going under sunbeds to get as complexionized as us. So we can't be doing nothing too wrong, y'all.
Yeah, well, I mean, something like that, a theory like that is stupidity, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
So that's to show you how ridiculous some of these scientists, doctors were.
Mm. Yeah. I mean, Why? What else? I mean, I don't even know what to ask you, to be fair, because, like, your knowledge is just the power that, of what you have, and I just, like...
Just anything. You ask me anything you want. What do you want to know about?
I want to know about everything. Like, we've got four... We've got... 45 minutes. So
when you do classes, how does it operate? Do you operate like I say, a 2 week, 6 week basis? Like, how does it?
Oh, okay. So just.
So you do courses in the.
Yeah. So if somebody says to me, like, for instance, I've been doing some courses in Tulse Hill.
Oh, Tulse Hill. It's around the corner from me.
Okay. And High Trees.
Yeah, so, High Trees. Yeah.
We do courses in there.
St. Martin's.
Yeah.
Exactly. Around the corner by the traffic lights.
Yeah, in there. Oh, exactly. No. Right by the traffic lights. Yeah.
Mm.
So for the last 4 weeks, 5 weeks, 6 weeks course.
Oh yeah.
Mm-hmm. So that's an example, and then I'll be doing another one, another term, maybe I think January there, I guess. So yeah, so basically they will commission me to do something there.
Oh, they commissioned you?
Yeah.
Oh wow.
Yeah. So and then so wherever the people want it,
mm-hmm.
I run a course. Whatever you want. You want 6 weeks, you want 10 weeks, 12 weeks, a month, what do you want? Do you want a Zoom? What do you want?
So how do people get onto
that? So hold on a minute, just before you get into that, Leesh. So it's a 6 week, and how long has that course been running? Are you going to have another one there again?
Yes, in January.
Cool. So how do people find out about it? How do you...
Well, we go online with High Trees and register with them and sign up for it.
Yeah. Well, what's the course called?
Africology.
Oh, that makes sense. No, but it could be...
We try to make sense.
No, because I mean, like, I know that's the foundation of what it is, but it could be focusing on a specific area. So you could be talking about geography of people of colour, you could be talking about...
It will always be Africology, and then whatever we teach, you know, whatever
comes under that. Exactly. So that's the umbrella term.
Yeah, indeed.
So, sort of me saying that's the umbrella term, what are different areas that come underneath Africology?
Africology. You get there eventually. Well, okay, look, what I always try to not just teach history. I mean, I don't always teach about Egyptology. Everyone wants to know about Egypt. Oh, thank you. But
Egypt is a big one, though.
It's a big one, but what I teach, I like to give people information that will make them understand the world is today. So,
okay.
So, as well as this black history, so-called black history, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
You have to understand, you know, how did things come to be? Mm-hmm. And if I'm teaching you something, what can it do for you now?
Okay. Yeah.
So I just want to teach you something that makes you feel good for half an hour.
Mm.
You know, get your endorphins going, and you say, "Oh yeah, we were pharaohs and that." Okay, great. But so what?
What now? Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? So that has a place. Don't get me wrong. But I want to teach people things that empower them, so they have understanding of what the world is now, how they get like that, and what can we do to change it. Yeah, that kind of thing. So that's what my main focus is: teaching history.
Well, you've got to know where you come from to know where you're going, don't you?
Precisely. So, yeah. And history is a journey, isn't it? So wherever we are now is a starting point for that.
Yeah.
You know, so how do we get here?
Mm.
And what's the forces at play there? Why don't you know about black history in schools? I mean, people campaigning in black history. Oh, of course, that's going to change now. You're going to start giving you things.
More things. But it is mental, the amount that it's just not there. It's not evident. Yeah, sure. Like we're non-existent.
Exactly. Yeah. The idea was that you have no history. So therefore, you're not fully human because you haven't contributed anything to civilization, development of humanity, and that kind of thing. That's the idea.
Mm-hmm.
So I can treat you any kind of
That's
way.
That's why they can do what
okay,
I do.
I'm going to ask you a question because, like, there's the question that we keep on asking is why do they hate us? I know, innit? Yo, innit? Blow
it was,
up.
It was only like
No.
It was only like this one.
Well, wasn't it the antifreeze?
You drink antifreeze?
No, for the first time.
Oh my days. Guys, let me just give you the telephone number in case anybody wants to ask Khareem any questions. The studio line number is 07988895055. That's 07988895055. If you have any questions that you might want to ask Khareem in the studio here today.
Ask away.
But the question that I want to ask is, or that I already asked, is we talk about us being hated so much, right? And like you just said, that they started to say that we wasn't human, so they could treat us the way that they treat us. But there's different little bits where people say, oh, because we've got, the men had the biggest penises, and you know, in terms of our skin, our melanin carbon skin, you know, this kind of stuff, and we're more powerful, and stuff like that. Yeah, what, from your understanding and from your research, would you be able to give a notion as to what it is, as to why we're treated the way we are, why they hate us so much, or do they even know why they hate us so much? Because it's just...
No, for the most part, no. Most people, the average man has no idea.
Mm.
He just has ideas handed down to him from his family. Oh, my dad came here. When he came here, you know, he was working amongst white people
mm-hmm.
in the early 60s.
Your dad came here from where?
From Antigua.
Okay.
And when he came here, he had no... Family wasn't here yet, so the workmates invite him home. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
and say, well, come and have a dinner with us and blah, 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 blah. So he went. And of mm-hmm. course, when he was going to sit down, they give him an extra cushion. He said, well, no, it's okay. The seat is comfy enough. And said, well, we don't want you to hurt your tail.
What?
Yeah, because they thought black people had tails.
Oh, my God.
I did hear something like that.
No, that and that is ignorance, because they weren't trying to be rude.
No, that's just that's what they were taught. Inside
yeah.
them, yeah.
So these things get handed down from grandfather to
yeah.
family.
Yeah, yeah.
It has no basis in fact or anything. Yeah. And they believe,
mm-hmm.
especially if you're not educated to where you might question something and
wow.
say, well, that's stupid.
Mm-hmm.
You see, remember, the masses of people are deliberately not educated. Even
mm-hmm.
even just white people, not black people.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. They tell you what they want you to know or need you to know.
Because they need you to be a worker.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
I need you to work in my factory. So I can't afford to educate you too much.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
Because you know too much, and then you want to be an entrepreneur.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not just black people out there. It's the poor white people as well. That are manipulated in that way, okay?
Yeah, yeah.
Good. So they got racism, but you also have a class struggle going on at the same time. So
mm-hmm.
most things are about class,
mm-hmm.
white or black.
Yeah, yeah, yeah,
yeah. So we have to have the underlayer in society where we
there
can,
has to be a hierarchy, isn't
exactly.
there?
Exactly. So that's the
yeah.
way, that's where there's capitalism.
And get behind them.
Mm.
Yeah.
Just more than antifreezes.
So just short of you continuing that bit, Elizabeth Rona asked, "Are the Ashkenazi Hebrew descendants?"
No.
Because it says, do you believe that the Ashkenazi are descended Hebrews? So you said no.
No.
So who are they?
Well, they're Ashkenazi.
Oh.
They're Khazarians. So they come from Khazaria originally, which was an old empire in sort of between the Caucasus and what we know as Russia today. So,
okay.
Yeah. So it's and you don't really know about Khazaria much. You don't teach it.
I've never heard of it.
Never heard of it.
Exactly.
And because it's spelled A-S-H...
No, that's Ashkenazi.
Oh.
Oh, Ashkenazim is the plural. So,
okay.
So, but there's two things. Ashkenazi and Khazaria. Khazaria.
Mm-hmm.
So that's where they come from. They have adopted the faith that we know as Judaism.
Oh, okay.
But they weren't born... in as Hebrews, you with me?
Right.
So it's like I don't know, like me and you say we're going to be a Hindu or something.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Traditionally,
right.
That's
right. Not our birthright.
That's not our thing, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's like when the rabbi was saying that Liza Minnelli, is it Liza?
Oh yeah.
He was saying she's married to a Jewish man, isn't it?
I think so. I don't know.
And he was saying that he was like, yeah. Well, she's not actually a Jew, but she thinks she's a Jew, and she gives us lots of money anyway. So hopefully when she dies, she's going to leave the money to our the Jews, isn't it? So
wow.
She's not a Jew, but we accept her because she gives us lots of money. And basically what he was saying, the crux of it is just about money.
Well, yeah, well, they are about money.
Yeah, that's what he said.
I mean,
so we're about our peace.
Like
but he said, can you blame us? He said, people allow us to, he said, well, we do it because we can get away with it. Like, no one's stopping us from doing it. So if they're not stopping us, why not? If you could do something, wouldn't you do what you can do? Do you know what I mean?
Mm.
Kind of thing. And it was like, well, it's true. Because if he was doing something and people wasn't stopping you from doing what you're doing, then yeah. So Elizabeth said, do you think we should have a homeland on the continent?
Which continent?
Did you want to go
lab? Okay, which continent, Elizabeth? She said, oh, okay, they're as descendants of the enslaved, the Khazarian Empire. Okay. All right, we're going to come back to that in 1 second, Elizabeth. We've got a caller. Okay, we've got a caller on the phone. Caller, what's your name and where are you calling from, please?
It's MJ, I'm calling from South London.
Hello, MJ, how are you?
Ooh.
I'm wonderful. What is your question? I know it's not for me because I can't answer you, but what is the question that you'd like to ask Khareem today?
No, but they were before the sort of view. Remember, slavery has always existed, but the slavery we're talking about is the slave trade, which is a completely different thing from me going to war with you, capturing you, and then making you. But what I've got now is a slave trade is where I'm selling you.
And making a monetary value of
it. And not only just selling you, but keeping you in that condition in perpetuity, that means forever.
Okay.
Yeah. So your children also belong to me, and your children's children, you see? And that's a completely different thing from the slavery, say, of like the Romans, where they would, go to war with another nation, capture them, maybe bring back some of the people back to Rome, because those people could still rise in their society to be something else.
Okay.
Yeah, they weren't limited to being slaves. They could still rise and they could get some position, wealth, and that kind of thing. This slave trade that we're talking about with Africans is a completely different thing. And it's also with several nations involved in it, not just one.
Mm.
Remember, it's a whole confederacy, isn't it? You've got Britain, you've got France, you've got Portugal, you've got Spain, you've got Belgium, you've got everyone, Holland, you've got all these people that want the piece of Africa.
Take a piece of it. Get a chunk.
So this whole, don't let anybody trick you. The slave trade is not like any other slavery that existed before.
Mm-hmm.
Completely different, yeah? As far as the Arabs concerned, Arabs, of course, came before the Europeans in many ways, but they weren't the first to enslave black people, no. But they have a role in that whole thing.
So thank you for your question, young man.
MJ.
MJ.
From South London.
From South London. Sorry, you know what? It's just because I'm just like...
Is that antifreeze you're drinking?
No, it's not that, Khareem. Stop telling people them that, man. Try and make me look bad on my show.
It's called temporary amnesia.
Listen, I've got temporary amnesia all the time. They know me, yeah. If they listen to this show, they know. I'd be like talking, I'd be like, I lost my train of thought. Was I talking about
it
again?
It can happen.
Happens weekly. No, really. It doesn't actually. My brain is very intellectual. It's got too much information, so I can't.
Okay.
So Elizabeth Verona said, in terms of, do you think we should have our own homeland on the continent of Africa?
Well, that is our homeland, isn't it? The question is, do we own our homeland?
No.
And the answer is no. So there is no independence. There's no independent black nation. Anyway,
that is mental.
It's crazy, isn't it? We every year we celebrate independence. We have these dances, don't we? Oh, we're celebrating
really
Jamaican
free.
Independence. We're celebrating.
Yeah, I don't even bother with it.
Ghana. There's no independence.
No, because everybody's still ruled by somebody else, isn't it?
Well, it's because the independence is an illusion. So I sell you the illusion that you're independent, but at the same time, I've still got a stranglehold on you.
Yeah,
economically.
Yeah, so Barbados, for example, is talking about they're going to dismantle the Queen in the next 2 years.
Dismantle the Queen would be that would be interesting, wouldn't it?
No, but for
one of
the
I know what you mean. I'm just taking literally.
No, I know, I know. But like I told you about my dictionary, right? I use words that sound good. The word might not be in the right connotation, but it goes with
limb
what I'm trying
limb.
To say.
Like, you know,
limb by limb, we have got coffee seated. Take off your court.
No.
All right.
I'm just hot.
You say you're just hot, yeah? Okay. Sing. Like I see better than anything there, but you know. Yeah, he's getting ready.
I'm good.
Big at yourself, Miss Caseman. How you doing? The feature in the house. Okay. So, yeah, okay.
So, homeland you were talking about, right? And I was saying that there's no independent black nation. Maybe the best or the closest we come to maybe is Cuba.
Cuba,
which is a fabulous place.
It is beautiful.
Cuba, it's not,
not just geographically or scenically.
No,
or
but they don't accept the powers of anyone outside.
Yeah,
Was it called a communist? No.
Well, they are communists.
Yeah, they're called
socialists.
Communists. Yes,
but that's not the reason I laud them or hail them as being.
What is the reason?
It's because of the system they set up there. I mean, Cuba has the best doctors in the world.
Cuba has the best doctors in the world.
Yeah, bar none. There's no other country anywhere that produces the quality of doctors that Cuba does.
Really?
And they, yeah, and they export them. They've been sending doctors to Africa, all different African nations. They've been helping Africa in the wars, in back independence against Rhodesia, in Rhodesia, South Africa, Angola, Mozambique. They send soldiers there, Castro.
Mm.
People don't know about these things. And they send doctors all over the world to help because their system there. They offer free scholarships to American students to come to Cuba to learn medicine.
Cuba offers...
Yes, exactly.
And America is messed up towards Cuba.
Exactly, yeah. That's my point. But they're still offering them free... All they say to you is, one thing we want you to do is go back and serve in your community.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's the only proviso.
Mm-hmm.
That's beautiful, right?
They've got good heart.
Oh,
that's
my
why.
God, that's
yeah.
right. Exactly,
yeah.
It's black people, right? So we have that heart. So we will teach you everything you need to know
mm-hmm.
for free.
Yeah.
But all you have to do is go back and serve in the community before you came.
And
from.
Use it, yeah. That's the payment.
That's beautiful.
That's good payment too. Yeah.
So Queen, do you know that word? Because you might know the word. This word, Queen of Fear. O-P-H-I-R.
I can't really can see because the background's white.
Yeah. Queen of Hair of Hair? Of Queen of Hair. Anyway, Queen of
Air. She's we're on air, right?
Really?
sorry.
Like, in my warm up, we know what we say. Blessings, Queen. No one's not. We're not disrespecting
you.
Oh,
no, not you.
We're just because, yeah. So she asks is what she asks is how do I submit? What do you mean by how do I submit?
Mm.
What do you mean? How do you submit to what? And the feature says, "I love Cuba. It's beautiful, isn't it?
Yeah, real.
I went to Cuba. Yeah." So I went to, we went on my mum's 60th birthday. So we went on a 60th cruise. It was 1 week cruise around all these different places.
Mm-hmm.
And then 1 week in Jamaica.
Yeah.
We went to Cuba and I wear a lot of cultural earrings. And I also sell a lot of cultural earrings. Anybody's interested? these ones.
Earrings, so I'm sorry.
But you got a hole in your ears though.
I used to.
Ah, you see. Trying to change
that?
The thing.
I mean, like, you know.
My eyes are good, man.
Okay.
Even without my glasses. But this woman, the particular earrings was wood colour, like a beige, and it was the shape of Africa.
Okay.
And when I say the woman come and cried to me, said, oh my God, she loves my earrings and it reminds her of her homeland and she wanted the earrings from my ears. And I took the earrings out of my ears and gave it to the woman that was bawling in my face because...
This is before COVID, right?
I can't even slap nothing.
Sorry.
Nah. Kareem, you didn't say that you was a drunk comedian as well, you know.
Exactly.
You get me? Like, oh, man. Oh, blessings. Yeah, but literally, like, I had to take that. Because she was just going on and how she's comes from, I can't remember what African country she came from.
Okay.
And she was living in Cuba. But she was just saying that my earrings just reminded of her of home. Like, and it was just so surreal that it was just like a pair of earrings. You couldn't make it up. Do you get what I mean?
Yeah.
So I just took them out of my ears and said, hey, you can
that's
have
beautiful.
It.
Yeah,
and she was just like, I don't know if she expected me to do it, but she was just like so grateful as well at the same time that I did it. It was nothing, can it? It's just a pair of earrings. But even though my earrings are very special to me as well. But yeah. And, but... Cuba was just, and they've got this big hefty statue that looks over the town of a Jesus. Was not, yeah, what's it called?
You're talking about Brazil?
Huh?
You're talking about Cuba or Brazil?
Cuba.
Okay.
I didn't go to Brazil.
Okay, I'm just wondering where you
Yeah, so you drive around, we drove around in them cars, and we went around to the next part of, and it's across the road from, what's his name? What's the, Shavaka?
Che Guevara.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Che Guevara. So his house is there. And like, just, you can, from where this big empty statue of this Jesus is, Che Guevara's old house is just literally just there.
Yeah.
And then you can look over the whole of Cuba like that. And it's just like, it's beautiful.
Yeah.
The music, the food, the people.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Like,
music.
Little alleyways you go down and everyone's selling cigars. Alleyways.
We're doing alleyways.
No, but and it wasn't in the alleyways, but we did go in the alleyways because they were selling us like the Cuban cigars, isn't it?
Okay.
So they were like, you know, people poach you on the streets when they're in countries you go to in different ways. They want to sell you something.
That's not where you got this rum from.
No, that was about 4 years ago now. So, yeah, you're cool with that.
Anyway. Yes.
So yeah, and you know, we went into their houses and we was, you know, and it was just like, it was just so surreal. Like people were just beautiful.
Yeah, no, they're friendly like that. That's beautiful.
Yeah,
it different, was different spirit altogether. And if you, as poor as they are, you know, people are happy. Yeah,
but,
you know what I mean?
But that's the thing about people. Poor people, yeah, are very happy. They're comfortable with their situation.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and they make the best of whatever it is that, well, that they have.
That's because maybe you haven't got this capitalistic ideology, you know, I must have this, and I want this, I want, you know, that's not how people, that's not how we live. Those are the kind of adopted kind of a kind of a materialistic,
capitalist Western society,
yeah,
ideologies.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
we're adopted because we live here, you know, so we become that way. So we need those things to be happy.
To make us, happy.
We don't need that.
So Queen of Fair, says that it means the city of gold.
Okay.
Queen, city of gold, the queen of gold, then, I'll say.
Lovely.
And she said, how do I submit music? So you're an artist then. Okay, so if you want to submit music for the late night talk show, it would be on L8 Night Talk Show. If it's on Top FM, if you go to the Ontop FM page,
send
a direct message and send a direct message to the late night talk show and then we'll help you out from there, basically. If you want the DJs to play your music is one thing, or if you want to come on a show and be interviewed is another thing. So to send a direct message to the late night talk show, which is L8, the word, the letter L, the number 8, and the word night talk show, and send us a direct message. It was 3 words, yeah. Night talk.
The word.
The words. You know I'm easily caught in it. You know that already. I'm slow. But we can hook you up in that way. So just going back over to Elizabeth, she said, I mean a pan-African state on the continent of Africa, a new country for the diaspora. So yeah, because you know what, a lot of people are saying that we need to have a pan-African. So one of my other friends, you know,
what does pan-African, the free, I know what pan-Asian is, like when you go to pan-Asian restaurant. I don't know, I'm asking.
No, look, can you come to the front? I need to sit down a bit. Because this girl just cracked me right up. She said pan-Asian, like eating food. I went pan-Asian restaurant on Monday, big up yourself.
Right, so I know what that, what is pan-African?
So basically people that are pro-Africa, want to return to Africa. To make it their homeland, okay? So, to like Marcus Garvey was the ultimate pan-Africanist.
Okay.
You know.
So they
if all things African. Really,
okay,
are,
I got you. Yeah. Okay.
So, and she's saying what
a pan-African.
Well, first of all,
how would you
create that?
Africa's not
nations,
even a country.
Well, it's not a country.
Yeah.
So you'd have to get those nations to create a separate homeland for people from diaspora to return. That's already happening anyway. Ghana is welcoming people from the diaspora.
Yeah, they are, right now.
Yeah, they're giving land and they're making it, you know, they're making it easier for people to come back home.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, Ghana has treaties with parts of Jamaica, like.
Brother, listen, don't even talk about Jamaica right now, because the man sell us out, yeah? I don't want to talk about that man there who sell us out to Richard Gates or Bill Gates. Who made him continue to be the parliamentary, the president, or whatever you want to call it, of Jamaica, and we're going to be, I'm British, so the Jamaicans are going to be the first one to be tested for corona.
No, that won't happen. That ain't going to happen.
He paid him, that's money he's paid.
Yeah, Jamaicans are going
to No, listen to this, How can Jamaica...
Stand up now, right?
Yeah, I have to stand up. Because how can Jamaica have a better system than England in terms of coronavirus?
And not just Jamaica, most of the African nations.
Exactly.
Most of the black
Jamaica's
nations.
A third world country. They claim we ain't got nothing. Yeah? But yet we've got a better system of people being tested and track and trace and all these things. Because what? Bill Gates paid off the man to do the thing and he took it.
No. Look, they told us that black people are more susceptible to the COVID virus is because we live in households where there's lots of people in there and poverty and all this kind of nonsense. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But yet in Africa and in the Caribbean, COVID's not killing us out there.
No, but initially, remember, they said that COVID can't survive in the heat. That was the first thing they said.
Is the key phrase. I don't care what they say.
Mm.
What do you see? You see, they say a lot of things. You don't mean you have to believe them.
Yeah.
You see, this is a... the false narrative that they create. That's what they are, they're magicians. They create stuff, people believe it, and run with that story. Yeah, so they're saying there's poverty, and because we're black people and we live in large households, that we're more susceptible to being to dying from COVID, right? But how come Africans ain't dying from COVID?
Yeah.
Like Caribbean's ain't dying
from
COVID.
From COVID, yeah. The death rates are minuscule compared to what
compared
they are.
To, yeah. Yeah. Well, and we're supposed to be third world countries.
Yeah,
yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And not supposed to have these sophisticated... sophisticated sort of a systems set up to deal with that.
Whom we know the systems they set up are definitely not sophisticated.
It's not good enough.
Yeah.
You know, someone somewhere is telling us a whole lot of nonsense.
Yeah.
And we just have to open our eyes and look at the facts rather than what people say.
Well, yeah, don't take the stuff on face value.
Exactly.
Do your own research. 100%,
yeah. That's right.
Yeah.
Exactly what we're talking about.
Agreed. We've got a caller, Ling, wants to go ask a question.
Ling, is it this way?
Yeah.
This way.
Hello.
Hi, Ling. Hi.
Hi, good morning to you all.
Hi. Oh, it is.
It is morning.
Oh, no, it's not morning
yet.
Yeah.
Nearly.
Okay. What was your question?
Okay, this is what I wanted to ask. Talking about the testing of COVID in the Caribbean, I wanted your guest to speak about the Tuskegee experiment, which is way before our time, but it's in, I think, the 20s or the 30s, when syphilis and what could happen in an adult body was tested on black men. And people trying to learn from their history as to where people have tested vaccinations and have tested all kinds of things on people and left them in a very distorted state.
Yeah.
I kind of won't take too much of your time because I know other people are texting and phoning in. I wanted him to speak about there was an African zoo in Belgium.
Oh, yeah.
Once again, before our time. I think it closed in the 50s. But that is where they used to keep African people who had been deliberately amputated in the Congo and other parts of Africa, so people could go and visit and have a look at them. So I'm going to leave you with those things in case of
those big things.
and a
little question that you're asking now.
love you, legs.
Yes, oh, bless you.
Love your spirit.
Thank
and
you.
I think you need to get the skip from Biggie Smalls that you can. Don't know.
You hit it. All right. Bless up, sis.
You
better send that to
you. When you do your shows the following week, you just have that and you just press the button. You don't know, now you know.
Big up yourself, Link. Back.
Thank you. Thank you.
One love. Blessings. So that was two things. She asked for you to.
Yes.
Boy, what time is it? We've got 20 minutes before the end of the show. Cool. So,
Well, Tuskegee, you know, is a place in Alabama.
Yeah, Alabama, America.
Correct. And they ran an experiment there with syphilis, where they injected black men with syphilis to see how we would cope with that. It's an experiment. Unbeknownst to them, of course, because no one's going to volunteer for that. And they observed us over decades.
Yeah.
So imagine an experiment with people over decades, years and years and years, to see how, whether they would cure themselves, whether it would be transmitted to the females, how, what would it do?
Let's
look at the, because we were looking at, they're looking at best of disease, because if thinking about those diseases like syphilis, any virus, most native populations never had these viruses. So the biggest weapon that Europeans had going back was themselves. All I would have to do is come into your community and people would be dying in droves. What kind of thing is that?
That is mental.
You think about that for a moment.
What are you saying?
So basically, them, themselves, they are what can kill the
toxic people.
That was their weapon. They were
without
the
even knowing. So if I come into a community that I've never been exposed to Europeans before, then thousands could possibly die just from the contact.
Wow.
Because the diseases that they bring with them, we had no experience, no exposure to them before. Particularly viruses.
Yeah.
COVIDs. Well, many COVIDs on there. Because from cold, it's a COVID. We never had those things. I say we, I'm talking about in Africa, people in Asia, in America.
Yeah.
The weapon was them, just being in your presence. Yeah. So these types of things we see now, and the lady mentioned the Tuskegee experiment with the syphilis experiment, is not new. Because in the 1700s in America, General Amherst, who was the governor of Ohio, I think it was making a treaty with the, names escaping for a minute, but the native tribes. Anyway, with the local Indians, okay?
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And he brought a blanket. Yeah.
As an actual gift. Blanket. Oh yeah.
Yeah, a small blanket, not another, you know, mm-hmm. More
Lord,
like
it
a carpet.
Sat on it.
Yes. It had
the Arawaku Indians.
No, American Indians. Oh. So I think it was a Pawnee, Shawnee, Sioux, and so on, a Confederacy of Americans. Peace treaty, here we are, is a gift, a token of our, you know, of our, the gift that we're bringing to you, token of our honesty, token to seal the bargain.
Yeah.
Here is a blanket. The blanket is has the infested with smallpox.
Did they know that?
No.
Oh. Okay.
Well, yes.
Wait.
The British knew that. Oh. But of course, the Americans didn't know that. So when we take that now back to our village, thousands are dying.
Can you just say that properly? Because you said that quite coherently or incoherently. So you said they came up with a blanket and said, here's a blanket, and the blanket was
a gift.
It was a token of our honesty,
the seal, the bargain.
Yeah, like a total, yeah,
exchange
like,
gifts.
This is us connecting ourselves,
exactly,
you know, like
yeah.
us getting married or
yeah.
whatever the
yeah,
thing
yeah,
is.
Yeah.
And it was infected with smallpox.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
How are they?
So this is germ warfare.
I didn't even hear about that one. I know about smallpox, but I didn't know about no blanket and all them thing there.
Yeah, yeah. So these types of things you see.
How
much
time have we got? How long can you stay here for?
As long as you want. So you know, so these things are not new.
Mm-hmm.
That's why history is so important.
Yes.
Because you can see that, you can see the possibility of things because they've happened before.
Yeah.
And you can see the fingerprints or the modus operandi of somebody, so I know your footprint.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because you've done it before.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a good question that the last lady made about the Tuskegee experiment. Yeah, and it's only in the, you know, the 80s or something that they issued some kind of half-hearted apology, you know, about it. Well, we don't want an apology. How are you going to fix this? Apologies are, you know, is nothing. That's a starting point.
Yeah, yeah.
That's the first thing. I'm sorry.
Mm.
Now what?
Reparations, isn't it? Yeah.
Reparations. Yeah. So you know, so there's many examples of these types of things that they've done before. You know.
Because
so.
Even it's short of history, it's still taking place now. Because
yeah.
if you talk about the polio in Africa, they brought in,
yeah.
They said that they're going to stop the people then from having polio, and they brought in all these vaccinations to give the
yeah.
African children polio.
Well,
and what happened is the kids have just continuously, even up until now,
yeah.
and the African government is still, obviously, whatever country it is, but the reality is they're still injecting these kids. These people are coming in and injecting these kids, and the children are becoming disabled.
Mm.
And they're still allowing them these vaccinations where they don't know what's in these vaccinations.
Well, not all. There's somebody like, excuse me. The question I would ask them if they came to me with that is like, show me a CV.
Mm.
When you go for a job, you have a CV, right?
Mm-hmm.
That shows you your history and gives me an idea of what you can do and what you've done.
Yeah.
Well, what's your CV towards black people? When you show me that CV, I'm saying, no, thank you. See you later.
Mm.
Because that CV is not good, right?
Yeah.
So since when have they been interested in preserving your life?
Never.
In the last 300 years, let's say. This narrative 300 years since the advent of white supremacy. They haven't. So what's turned? What's changed now? So when Bill Gates come with his Trojan horse, that's what I call it, because you have to look that gift horse in the mouth because something else is inside there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know,
definitely.
It's not what they're presenting.
Yeah.
So Bill Gates is a devil. I'll say that anywhere.
Mm-hmm. I'll back you
anywhere,
up.
Anywhere, to his face, wherever, he's a devil. And because if you know, this is where history comes in, because I know, if you know about his father is Bill Gates Sr., who along with Margaret Sanger created Planned Parenthood, which is a eugenicist organization.
Oh, and they've still got that.
They're still there now.
Yeah,
they get billions every year from government
yeah.
funds. And that is to say, basically the premise of that is to say who can have children, who can't.
Yes.
So
sterilization.
I know about that.
So that's where Bill Gates comes from. So his father and his mother were in that. So Microsoft is just a means of making money so that he can do
they
what he really wants
that.
To do.
Yeah.
Exactly. So, and that's why they left, leaving what, $30 billion, him and Warren Buffett, to the Bill and Melinda Gates Society for is eugenics, which is population control and reduction.
You hear that?
And where they want to start in Africa with that stuff, right?
Yeah, so, but they're not started. They've already started that.
Yeah,
that's been
right.
ongoing for years. They've been what's that? Sterilizing African people, people of color. They've been sterilizing. So, Miss CJ said, "Talk the things." Talking about Jamaica, Sisterly Love saying, "What the hell?" Yes, so we knew that. It's mad. Miss CJ said, "What about India?" And they're saying that's why some people need to open their eyes. It happened back then. Imagine what they're doing now.
Exactly, yeah.
Same thing they did in India. And she said they must be working themselves around the globe, seriously, killing off the people, they're making them disabled, etc. Mad.
Well, look, this idea of overpopulation that you keep hearing, you know, and global warming,
yeah,
all this stuff is part of the same agenda. So when people, this whole idea of eugenicism, it starts, eugenicism starts a couple hundred years ago, where people are saying there's too many people on the earth, even when it was only like 2 billion.
Yeah.
So now you've got 7 billion. And you've got people who are really, you know, people like Prince Philip, Prince Charles, the World Life Fund, all of these things are connected with that. You've got John Kellogg, the man who makes your cereal. Go back to the original of that. He is a eugenicist. He's a, you know, he believes there's too many people in the world. So if that man who believes there's too many people in the world,
because he's got something
making my food,
cyanide or something in the food that he's putting in.
I've got to be worried, right?
Yeah.
So this guy is saying there's too many people in the world and he's making food for us to eat.
Mm-hmm.
Then we should be worried about that. We shouldn't be eating that.
I did hear that. I know it's a bit little bit off here, but like cornflakes was originally made for in like mad homes, so they'll put in the stuff so that they could hear when they were moving or something like that. Which is mad how it then became a cereal. So,
yeah, well, that's Kellogg's. Kellogg's cornflakes.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. He was John Kellogg. Was
so he's Genesis. Involved in that as well.
Oh yeah, that's these.
Oh Lord.
So there'll be some people that are named that you'd be really surprised that they want to reduce. Oh my God.
Yeah.
They want to reduce the population of the world. That's what they believe.
Mm.
You know, they believe that there's too many people.
Why? Well, obviously you can't say why they believe this, but
well, it's
about control, though.
Control
isn't it?
And power.
It's about control and power.
Controlling resources, controlling that. So, for instance, all of these wars you've seen in the last 20 years, the Gulf War, all the Afghanistan, Libya, all of those things, are not just being planned now.
No,
okay.
They've been planned in the '70s.
Yeah.
When Jimmy Carter was president and Nixon before him, they this guy Henry Kissinger. Who served in about 6 or 7 administrations. He's like, he can't die. You know, this guy, he's been advising them on what to do. So they had a thing called Project for the New American Century, in which they're looking in the next 100 years, where the resources are that we need to survive as America. Yeah, where do we get them from? Where do we get oil from?
Mm.
Where do we get this from? Because we're gonna need it, because they're projecting on population.
Okay.
How many people are going to have in 100 years if the current rate of thing goes on? That's what they do. They have think tanks. Think tanks sit down with the best brains.
Yeah.
What do we do how do we plan society? How do we orchestrate behavior of people? How do we, you know, manipulate the minds of people? If we do this, then they're going to do that.
Mm.
We do A, that B will happen. Mm. That's how they do.
Yeah.
So they know if we do certain things that they will have certain reactions. Okay. So the Project for New American Century was looking at where can America get resources from that will sustain them for the next 300, 400, 500 years, whatever, okay?
Okay, yeah.
And one of those things is oil. So they, in that document, you will see them talking about, you can find it, you can go get this in the American Library of Congress. Just, things are there, they put it out there, you just need to know where to access it.
They put it there, right in front of you.
Yeah, hidden in plain sight.
But it's, yeah.
That's what it is. So you
it's
go
right in front of your face. Yeah. That's what the Jewish man said. He said, "We put it in front of your face, but you don't believe us. We told you that we take the bodies, and McDonald's is made of dead people, crushed up, and we told you this, and you don't want to believe us. So keep on eating it.
Yeah.
Can you not stop giving my kids flipping McDonald's, please? Seriously.
Your children, not kids.
My children, sorry. Can you stop giving them McDonald's, please?
Yeah, go to kids, right?
Yeah.
But anyway, so you'll see countries like Afghanistan mentioned in that document.
That's what he talked about.
You'll see countries like Iraq. You see Libya.
Mm-hmm.
All these countries are mentioned in that document. That this is the country we need to get control of to get the oil we need to sustain us.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Planned 40 years ago, 50 years ago.
More than that.
Yeah, so.
I'm going to say in my video.
Yeah, and that's what's happening now. So we see everything manifested in our time.
Listen, there's a video, remember I was telling you about it, It was 65 years ago, And the man said, the last 40 seconds of the video is flying around this video, And the man said in the year 2020, there's going to be a pandemic, or what's the other word? We say epidemic. What's the word?
Pandemic.
Yeah, there's going to be a pandemic, In 2020, where there's going to be a flu-like disease that comes from China, the Asian population, which is gonna create what's been created now. The man said that 65 years ago.
Well, that's what they planned.
65 years ago, the man's talking about this coronavirus thing. That's all. Now you tell me. I said, but mum, that was just before you was born. They didn't even have TVs. He was talking about aeroplanes. We didn't even have aeroplanes the way that they had aeroplanes now. Mm. They had like one or two. And he's saying, yeah, aeroplanes, all of these things that you wanted. And it was like he was talking about manifestation and all this kind of stuff. And then he went and said about in 2020, like, he already knew Wagwan for now.
Well, they don't do things in a spur of the moment. They plan.
No, they do plan. They do.
I mean, actually, going back to the young lady, I think you asked two questions, didn't you?
She did ask two questions. One was like Tusky. She talked about the Belgium and the zoo. She was kind of asking the clarification of if that's correct.
Yeah, well, Belgium, obviously, we have to mention the connection with Belgium and Africa anyway, which is established by Leopold II in the Berlin Conference, which I did a big lecture on about in the summer. Berlin Conference, Leopold II of Belgium gets Congo, the richest place in the world.
Mm-hmm. Congo, yeah.
There's actually something going on in Congo right now. Oh,
right now,
there?
Everyone's hustling for Congo because Congo's got more resources than anywhere else.
Yeah.
Everything you want to find is in the Congo.
But it's broke down. The Congo was for ages. They broke it down. You haven't heard a lot about Congo, and now it's come back up.
So what they used to do with it is they used to, when they were, it was rubber initially in the early part of the 20th century. That's what Congo had, lots of rubber. And when, because of the Industrial Revolution with cars and all the kind of things, there was a big demand for rubber. Yeah. So when the African, when the Congolese weren't producing rubber quick enough, they used to chop off their hands.
Yeah, I learned about that,
As an example.
And then they got chocolate hands even there as ornaments now.
Exactly.
And people only have just started realizing with the use of social media what it actually represents, because Nobody knew that.
So that's where that came from. And also, they used to put in black people in on display because of the different physical types that we have. So I don't know if you remember a picture of Sarah Bartman.
Yeah, with the backside.
So you remember the European women used to create these scaffolding, I call it, you know, where they...
In the dresses.
That's to imitate that. Because they haven't got the shape, you see. So that's what they used to put that on. Which really looks really crazy, right?
The wiring.
So they used to put Sarah Bartman, they had her in a virtually a zoo, touring around, people looking at her because of her large posterior.
Yeah.
And saying, oh my God, look at this.
Oh, you're talking about Sarah Bartman.
Yeah. So that's in response to the question about the zoo. So they've always been putting this on display, you know, just because of our different physical types. We've got many. And there's no typical black man or woman. You know, people say a typical black man. That's nonsense. There's no such thing.
Mm-hmm.
We've got so many different types, so many looks, so many different complexions, so many different physical types.
Mm-hmm.
Tall, short, big, small, straight nose, big nose, whatever. We've got more. And it's nothing to do with mixtures with anybody else. That's just us. We produce everything. Blue eyes, green eyes, which is that's just partial albinism.
Yeah.
People don't know that. So freckles, that's partial albinism.
But people don't even know that blue eyes is actually a disease. They think
it's not a disease, it's a defect.
It's a defect,
DNA. So your DNA goes from something wrong, that's with partially albinism, freckles, ginger hair, blonde hair,
gray
hair, green eyes. Yeah, so you...
Trans have got a defect?
No, you're not defective. I'm just saying something in the DNA has malfunctioned.
Really?
Yes.
It's all right. It's all right. Don't worry about it.
We have degrees of that. People have some degree, some have total albinism where they have white hair and the skin. Some have just, you might see patchy on the skin with it. It's just that. So this is partial albinism, it's a slight defect in the DNA.
Mm-hmm.
And so these things, you know, we produce all types of looks, shall we say.
Everything across the spectrum.
Just Old Tank said this is painful history.
Well,
and people are saying wow and yes and true in terms of the stuff. So
there's detox, isn't it? And it's cold turkey. So it's painful. So with history, you have to go through that, you know.
Yeah.
You can't.
But but you say that. I don't know if you can go through cold turkey. Because when I hear some of this stuff sometimes, and I go out and I see certain cultures, and I'm just like, so I have to hear these things when I'm sitting in my house where I can't go nowhere. And I can't. Not that I'm going to
digest.
But just digest it and just take it on and just like, okay, cool. Because, you know, like, you know, we talk about energy and stuff like that. Not to say that it's negative energy, but it is negative energy. It's negativity that has been portrayed onto us as a people. Mm-hmm. And it's just...
But we have to understand that, so we understand the program, we understand where things happen, we understand the possibilities. See, because, and it's not just, you can't just categorize and say, oh, white people are this and that. No, it's, you have a certain elite people.
Yeah, yeah.
That even manipulate their own.
Yeah, no, but that's the reality of isn't it? Because it's like, it's who you can brainwash. So even they brainwash the white people to think that they are superior.
Correct.
The poor white people to think that they're superior to the black people, so they can treat us the way that they treat us without realizing that we're all on the same level.
Absolutely, 100%.
You ain't got nothing, I ain't got nothing, but you want to act like you got something more than me. Oh, I'm your bridging.
More for you, right?
You understand?
Exactly, yeah. So that's exactly what's happening. So we pit them off against each other. When they're fighting each other, then we can just do what we do.
Against each other.
See, because you're not focused on it. So yeah. It's like Hollywood. Hollywood is a distraction for us. Movies are a distraction.
Mm.
It's entertainment, they say, but it's not the real focus of the product. The product is to miseducate you and to distract you. Mm-hmm. So now you have 24-hour TV. You can't focus on how many people know about politics, how many people know what's going on in the world. You don't, because you're watching TV all the time. Movies, 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 yeah? Mm-hmm. Yeah. And what are the movies? Most movies, I mean, you look, talking about British history, the movie Gladiator, you know, we talk about that a lot. The movie Gladiator, remember the Russell Crowe?
Yeah.
So this is set in a period of history, in Roman history, 193 AD, where you have a black, what will happen is a black Roman emperor called Septimius Severus ruling in Britain.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But for him to, when you see that opening shot in that movie, really, instead of seeing Russell Crowe there, you should be seeing a black man there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because in reality, that area of what's called Pannonia, which includes parts of Germany and so on, was governed by a black general called Septimius Severus. Britain, at the same time, was the governor was a man named Clodius Albinus. What does that tell you about his name?
Albinus of Albina.
Yeah. And and Syria and Palestine was governed by a man named called Pisenius Niger. What does that tell you about him?
He was African.
Yeah.
Okay, so unfortunately, we've got less than a minute left of the show. Wow.
This is so inspiring, like.
Yeah.
Now, seriously, can you come back next week? We haven't got a guest. Have we got a guest for next week yet?
Don't think we do, you know.
Boy, we ain't. So if you can come back next week, I'd really appreciate part two of you continuing.
I can do that.
You need to remember what you told us already, yeah? Mind you bang your head. Not much, you just go,
oh! Remember what I told you already, okay.
No, well, we'll listen back to it and just check. But I mean, you just to say, that's why I can relate to the movie so much, that movie so much. Guys, thank you so much, Khareem. The adverts might start, so I don't even know if I can even thingy bob, so.
Yes, they will.
For those listening, that's you. But for those that's on the, yeah, so for you guys, if you can just tell the people that's on the social media where they can find your information and get some more short of listening to us next week.
Facebook is at Africology. You can find some there. And also Instagram, same. Twitter, just put at Africology.
Just put Africology.
Yeah, Instagram and things in there. And tomorrow's Thursday, right?
Yeah, tomorrow's Thursday.
I have a Zoom lecture tomorrow. This month we're featuring black women in history.
Mm-hmm.
So tomorrow I'm talking about Sophie Nisba. I'm talking about...
You're talking about a what?
Sophie Nisba.
So who?
Sophie Nisba.
Sophie Nisba, yeah.
What is that?
Tune in tomorrow, you plan. Sophie Nisba and Sojourner Truth and Nanny. So we just begin love tonight.
Excellent, that's wonderful. Thank you so much. So I'm going to post what's happening tomorrow on the Late Night Talk Show. So make sure you're watching L8 Night Talk Show. And basically you'll find out what is the Zoom is tomorrow.
Sure.
Is it a free Zoom or do they have to pay?
No, we have to pay this one. Normally
we have to pay. It's what it is. You can't pay for it. It's not always free.
It's three episodes. And it's
three episodes.
You get one free if you buy them all.
See?
Okay. £15.
£15.
That's not bad.
Buy one and you get how much free?
Buy two, get one free.
See? Cool. Yeah. So, Just Those Hank says, Hidden Colours is bringing out a lot of information that you can read on Hidden Colours.
Mm-hmm.
But short of Hidden Colours, it's a late night talk show every Wednesday from 10 to 12 on Ontop FM. Make sure you're following us. Make sure you check out our YouTube page as well. Get following and subscribe to our YouTube page so we can do stuff with you on YouTube. I want you to follow us on YouTube.
Okay, they heard you.
Living colours, right? That's where we are. Living colours.
Hidden colours.
No, we are living.
We are living colours, but we're not hiding.
Indeed.
Perfect. Thanks, guys.
Thank you, guys. Stay blessed, stay well, and catch you next week. Thank you.